Hello everyone, welcome to the day 17 of the NABARD Grade A 5 question series, and in this video I'm going to discuss the important ARD questions, that is the agriculture and rural development. Also, there will be one question at the end of the video for you which you need to answer in the comment section. Before starting with the video, let me tell you about the spotlight which is available for the April month on the website, and soon we'll upload the May spotlight as well. So you just need, it might look a very comprehensive current affairs magazine to you, but it's very important for the upcoming examination. So just go through that magazine to cover all the current affairs. Now let's begin with the first question for the today, day 17. The first question is, soil mulch is useful in. Now I have already discussed about this soil mulching in the previous video, where mulching is basically any material that is being spread or put on the surface of the soil as the covering, which you can see in this picture as well. So it could be newspaper, the compost, the leaves, the dried leaves, these could be used as the soil mulching. So there are various reasons why soil mulching is being done. Let's look at these options and analyze where these options are in respect with the soil mulching or not. The first being improving aeration. Now this could not be the agenda of soil mulching, because we are covering the soil. If we are covering the soil, that does not mean that we are providing aeration to the soil. Next is minimizing evaporation losses. Now this can be the answer of this question, reason being, when we are covering the soil, then the less of the soil area is exposed to the air or sun, therefore there is minimizing of evaporation. Now this cannot be the answer, because drainage cannot be improved because of the soil mulching. Next being removing weeds. Now this is a partial correct statement, reason being, we cannot remove the weeds completely with the help of soil mulching, but we can restrict the growth of, or we can suppress the weed growth. So rather than saying removing, it could be reducing the weed growth. That could be the agenda of the soil mulching. So this cannot be the answer, because removing weeds is not the agenda of soil mulching. Next one, providing loose soil bed for roots. Now this is incorrect. Why? Because when we are providing this soil mulching, then we are providing a concrete bed for the roots as well. So the answer for this question is in minimizing the evaporation loss. Also, the soil erosion is reduced with the help of soil mulching. We have heard about the mulching tillage as well, stubble mulching tillage, where the residue of the previous crop is being covered or put on the field so that we could stop the erosion as well. Next question, the important one. So which of the following is the critical stage for maize? Now there are various critical stages for the different crops. The critical stage means the time when the crop needs the supervision at its highest. So basically when the crops need the supervision, care at the most, that stage is known as the critical stage. So what is the critical stage for maize? So the tasseling stage is known as the critical stage for maize. Now what is this tassel? So basically this tassel represents the male flower which is on the corn plant, and the ear shoots represent the, so these ear shoots represent the female part. Now this tassel, this growing of the tassel is basically the critical stage for maize, reason being the germination. So therefore the tasseling is the critical stage for maize. Now let's look at the other critical stages, irrigation critical stages for different crops. For rice and paddy, tillering is one of the very critical stages of rice. Next is weed. So crown root initiation, that is CRI, this is one of the very important critical stage of the crop. So what is this root crown? So root crown is that part of the root system from which the stem arises. You can see the crown over here. So this is that part of the system where from the root system from which the stem arises. Therefore, it becomes the important and the critical stage of wheat. So a question might come on these stages as well. You can just pause the video and take the screenshot of this picture. Moving on to the next question, so which of the following are considered as the drought tolerant crops? Now drought tolerant crops means the crops which are not sensitive, or they have low sensitivity to drought. Low sensitivity basically which means that the requirement of water is comparatively less than the other crops. So which of the following are considered as drought tolerant crops? Jowar and bajra, they both are considered as the drought tolerant crops. But when we talk about banana, so banana is highly sensitive to drought. Now, these are some of the sensitivity of various field crops to water shortages. So, in terms of low sensitivity, that means the drought-tolerant crops, cassava, cotton, millet, pigeon pea, sorghum. The highly sensitive crops are banana, fresh green, paddy rice, potato and sugarcane. And there was one question on sugarcane, the water requirement for sugarcane in the previous examination. So you need to learn about the different sensitivity, basically the water requirement of the different crops. So this table shows the approximate values of the seasonal crop and their water needs. So this means that this is somewhat the bare minimum or average water requirements. So if we look at this table, so banana, rice and sugarcane, they are among the crops which have the highest requirement, and the citrus as well. So they are among the crops which have the high requirement for water, thus they are not drought tolerant. Now the water requirements also depends upon various factors. So there being three factors, the major three factors, the first one being the climate. So this means that if the climate is sunny and hot, then the water requirement is more. Next is the crop type. So if, as I just mentioned over here, the requirement for banana is more, at the same time the water requirement for melon and onion is less. The third factor being the growth stage. So what happens, usually it is found that the crops which are grown, they have high requirement of water as compared to the crops which are just planted. So the just planted crops have little requirement or less requirement of water as compared to the fully grown crops. Next is choose the most appropriate answer. Which of the following is not the major factor to choose the method of sowing? So the crop species to be grown, this is one of the major factors of sowing of seeds. Next is ease in planting. So sometimes the requirement of the farm is such that the seeds need to be grown closely, or the seed needs to be grown with a perfect distance. So therefore ease in planting is also important. Next is the sowing rate. Obviously the sowing rate is as important as the sowing method. Another one being the climate. So climate is not the major factor when we are considering the methods of sowing. Reason being, climate is considered at the time of irrigation. So if there is monsoon prone climate, then the crop should be grown where the requirement of water is more. So if climate affects the irrigation, it does not affect the method of sowing. Next one being the financial capability of the farmer. So if the farmer could not afford the method of sowing, for example, dibbler or drilling methods could not be used because the machinery is required. Therefore, it's not capable, or the financial capability of the farmer does not support him to go for the mechanical sowing. For different methods of sowing, I have already discussed in the day 13 of the ARD question series. Do watch that video. I've discussed different methods of sowing, how they are being sown and how the seeds are being sown, what tools are being used. So do watch that video for different methods of sowing. Next question is, which of the following is not the method of irrigation? Now there are different methods of irrigation. These are surface, sprinkler, trickle and subsurface. But broadcasting is the method of sowing. So as I just mentioned, you can just go to the video day 13 of NABARD video series, and there you can find the different methods of sowing. Now coming to the methods of irrigation. So these are the four different methods of irrigation. Let's just have a look at these different methods. So in simple terms, when the water is distributed over and across the land with the flow of gravity. So basically flooding of the land. So sprinkler is more of artificial rain which is being done, or the method which is used as the irrigation. Next, trickle, which is also known as drip irrigation, and it is the method, the localized irrigation method, in which the drops of the water are delivered at or near the roots. Next one being the subsurface. So the water is distributed across the land by raising the water table. So these are the different methods, and I'll be discussing about these irrigation methods in detail in the next video, that is the day 18 of the NABARD question series. Do watch that video for covering the irrigation topic. Now it's the common time for you. When was the PMKSY scheme launched? So you need to mention in the comment section, when was this Pradhan Mantri KSY scheme launched? You can also mention the full form as well, but the launch year needs to be mentioned. So do mention that launch year. Now, as I just mentioned, do watch the day 13 question series where I've covered the methods of sowing. It's very important. And for covering the irrigation method, watch the next video, that is day 18. which will soon be available on YouTube. If you have learned anything from this video, do not forget to subscribe to our channel Anuj Jindal. Also, press the bell icon to receive the notification as and when the video is being posted. You can share these videos with the people who are preparing so that they can also learn about the different topics which are important for the NABARD examination. Thank you so much for watching the video.